Last time, we reviewed Sylvester Stallone's version of the real Rambo movie knife, and basically, it sucked. Pretty hard, actually. However, that knife was based on this knife, the Pohl Force MK9 Last Blood CNC 2 edition. We got this knife as comparison from our viewer, Michael, and after seeing our other Rambo knife video, he told us we could carefully beat it up as well. Sadly, we don't really know what careful is, so we messed it all up. Anyway, first it's time for our sponsor, Civivi! Yeah! Civivi conquered the EDC world with one particular knife. The price was great and the performance even better. I'm talking about the Civivi Elementum. Backed by many positive reviews, people want more! Well, meet the Civivi Elementum family. The workhorse, fixed blade Elementum. The do-it-all, button lock Elementum. The tactical Elementum flipper. And the beauty, Elementum drop-ons. And the cutie pie, aka mini Elementum. There's literally an Elementum for everyone's taste and need. You can find all colors, shapes, and sizes on their website. Civivi Elementum in 5 words: smooth, affordable, EDC friendly, well-balanced, sharp. Check out the Civivi Elementum family and get your new companion now! Link in the description. Wow, how's that for a start of the video? I made like 3 chops and this thing is already rattling. So,
is that fixable?
Well, yeah, let's check it out. And also this thing, even though that this is a better knife or a more expensive knife, this thing still hurts, but I think there's a solution.
Mikkie, that small steel thing is supposed to keep it from rattling, okay?
Yeah. It doesn't look like this is made for abuse at all. Oh yes. Oh, now it actually feels like a knife. That's not a knife. That's a knife. So, but this is a big difference. I mean, 90% of the tasks that the other knife could not do, this one now can.
Like the reverse grip?
Carving, chopping. We're not killing. Guys, come on. Bushcrafting.
Sylvester Stallone's knife seemed like it would break already here, whereas this knife feels much better with this task, especially with that strange handle thing removed.
The rattling has got so much worse already. Nevertheless, for chopping, I would give this knife a 6. That's a whole lot better than the other knife.
Yeah.
Rambo, dude. Oh, my name is Rambo. My name is Rambo, dude.
The next thing we had to do was carve a weapon, just like in the other video where the Sylvester Stallone knife made that, well, absolutely impossible for us because of that handle thing again. But also that grind and everything, yeah, it just sucked.
It is absolutely crazy how much better this knife carves than the Sylvester Stallone endorsed Rambo knife.
Yeah, just without the finger shit on the handle.
Yeah, and I mean, it has a nice musical touch. Nevertheless, it does carve. So I mean, yeah, it's still a movie prop. I spit a little. That was absolutely not possible. And I have to say, it's not even half bad.
We think that one of the big reasons that this knife also carved better because it was way sharper, actually shockingly sharp. Here's a scale that measures the amount of force to cut a wire, the lower the better, and just know that 200 grams of cutting force already shaves.
Oh! Pohl Force, my man!
Very sharp, man. It's very sharp.
Way better than the replica. And the replica wasn't even bad.
Oh yeah, and that weapon turned out to be a tent peg. A real Rambo manly tent peg, though.
You might think that this is a tent peg. But only a Rambo knife can make a tent peg. Can make from a tent peg a weapon. How does this compare to the other knife?
Well, without the finger thing, whatever it's called, this feels really a lot more comfortable in the hand while batoning.
But there's one piece that the Rambo knife could not do. Because it was just also, we found out that it was just a hell of a piece.
Yeah, that was this.
And I think now the job is for you to actually do it. Oh! 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 Whoa, holy shit! Well, that is next level.
Yeah, so that already says that this grind is so much better than the hollow grind for splitting wood.
Yeah. Whoa, I'm actually very surprised by that.
Yeah.
You know what, Marta, the other knife filled with this.
Oh.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, but Mikkie, the other knife already snapped there. Whoa!
That's how easy it breaks! It did not break.
Okay, hey, but Mikkie, can I say something?
It did not break.
And
it did not break! That already says that this knife is way sturdier than the other knife, while yeah. the steel was also pretty much an upgrade. I mean,
it was 440B. This was 440B over the 440A.
And the other knife was not even able to feather stick. And this knife, okay, I can already feel that this is doing a pretty good job.
Way better grind. And really sharp.
Six and a half for feather stick. You know? Mikkie, it's really good for a knife this size and this strange grind and shape that it has.
I'm actually really happy that we are able to test this knife now, and I'm actually starting to think it might survive shooting.
Yeah.
But then something happened that really surprised us.
This is on par with Lily's knife.
Whoa!
This is actually so aggressive that sometimes, look at this.
Whoa, it actually—
That's fire steel.
Whoa, okay. That literally was the second scraping. Is this?
I'm gonna give this a 9.5 for visor scraping.
Oh, Jesus. I mean, and it wouldn't have to have this. I mean,
no.
This is only a movie prop.
At this point, I was pretty certain that this knife would not break during the shooting test, which by the way follows the YouTube guidelines and is done on private terrain at 30 minutes distance. Yes, but this knife was way thicker and felt sturdier than the Sylvester Stallone HeartStopper knife.
No, is it damaged?
It happened again.
Did it happen again?
Yeah.
Oh no.
It happened again.
Oh no, shoot it again. I'm sorry, Michael. I'm so sorry, Michael.
I really thought that this knife would be a lot sturdier.
Yeah, but it's just the 440 steel.
Oh, it did withheld that shot.
Last shot. One. Oh my God.
Sorry, ladies and gentlemen. I mean, this rifle shoots hard, but with a knife this thick, it should survive this. I mean, we've seen a $10 knife survive this.
Yeah, and it's not that 440B is extremely hard steel.
No, and look, it is actually pretty significant damage, Martin.
Yeah, this is like the same as the 440A, man.
Yeah, it reacts exactly the same. And look. Look how thick that is. That is so thick.
That is really thick. And now if you put it in someone's heart and you pull it out, you have the heart. It comes out with it.
Michael, sorry, man.
Yeah.
Sorry, this really wasn't our intention. I mean, yeah.
We shot it.
How can we say that if we actually shot it?
But you know what is my intention?
What?
To have a giveaway every month.
Jesus.
And this is
really
a brand spanking
really
new giveaway.
That Michael wins it.
Ladies and gentlemen, this month we are giving away the Falcon Even A1X thanks to DBK. We are giving away the PMP Alpha Beast thanks to Tools for Gents. We are giving away the Bark River Bushcraft Ultralight thanks to Bladed Skew. We are giving away the Drop Forge Survivalist thanks to Coast to Deutschland. We are giving away the Rife Knives F6 and F4. Crazy. And we are giving away the whole Civivi Elemental family thanks to Civivi. Winners of the last giveaway will be mentioned later this month because I am in Thailand.
Well, okay. I'm actually not really sure what to think of this because when you shoot a knife and it breaks, it doesn't necessarily mean it's a bad knife.
No.
However, if a knife this thick and this expensive breaks because of that, it means that the steel is not strong enough.
Okay, can I say that in every aspect, the Pohl Force is a way higher quality replica knife as the one on the Sylvester Stallone shop?
I
in every way.
I wouldn't really trust it to do heavy work because, you know, with four chops, this finger guard was already rattling. But it is fun to know that if you buy a movie prop, which it is, this is a movie prop.
Yeah.
I mean, let's make no mistake about
it. But I gotta say, he rated it field grade. Field grade, meaning it's a little bit less quality, but it does sound like you can take it into the field. Yeah.
I do also think that a knife this expensive, what are you paying for? Because it is a replica of the knife in the movie. It shouldn't be that expensive.
Okay.
And otherwise, if you make it that expensive, it is. Yep. You might as well just give it good steel. Why wouldn't you?
And then people are gonna ask us, hey, test the Pohl Force MK9 because that is like the original knife behind this knife.
Yeah.
And then even that knife is around 300 euros and it's D2 steel, which probably will also break when shooting it.
Yeah. One last thing, if that little thing here in the handle wasn't removable, this knife would have been shit as well.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, that's just how simple it is.
Thank you very much for watching.
Oh, wait, hey, come back. Please like and subscribe for the algorithm, hey guys. Watch us every Thursday, 1 p.m. PDT. And thank you very, very much. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. Bye.